Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to CBS Sports coverage of the NCAA tournament. Today's game is between the Richmond Spiders and the Providence Friars. And our starting lineup.
We have two excellent players at the point guard position. They usually do a great job of getting their teammates involved. Something we should definitely keep an eye on, Gus.
And here's what the plan of attack is for either team in regards to tempo. So here we go.
Gus, it looks like they're going with the minimum.
Out on the left wing. And it's blocked. Hopkins, loose ball, great play. Oh, handles the feed. The Friars working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
They've worked the perimeter. It's stripped. Active hands. Both teams are looking to get something going here. On the right side. He shoots from the corner. No, cleans the glass. Way out on the right wing. Shots up. Oh! When you can pass and score like he does, it makes a coach's job a bit easier.
You know he's a real talent. He can set up his teammates for open looks and really has a nose for the goal.
On the left side. The fans are making a difference, Rap. This is a tough place to play. On the right side, he unloads the three. Comes up empty from deep. Want to thank you for joining us tonight. I'm Gus Johnson, and joining me, the man with all of the insight, the governor, Bill Raftery. Careless mistake there. Out on the wing. Jump shot. He missed it.
Get out and fill.
On the right side.
Fired. Squared up on the catch. Got his puppies in order.
Cross court. Jump shot.
How about that, Gus?
They've worked the perimeter. Fired. And he can't get the bounce. Inside. Every roster needs a few of those type of players. A blue-collar type who's not afraid to get dirty.
He may be blue-collar, but he brings an intensity that not many guys do.
Kelly handles the pass. In the lane. He can't get it to go. Pulls down the board. On the wing. Dials up a long-range shot. Not this time.
Boy, the coach will be happy with that effort.
Out on the left wing. Now with 10 to shoot. Hoover receives the pass. Jump shot. Shots off. Pulls it down.
Oh, receives the ball.
Fires. Count it. And he throws it right away. Great steal. Now they work it around the perimeter. Off the mark, grabs the board. On the left side. He attempts the trifecta. Got it.
Wow.
You can blink and he could have 20 on you. This young man can put the biscuit in the basket.
He's a scorer. He has a knack to put the ball in the hole.
Got it in the low block. Jump shot. No.
Oh, competitive, Gus.
Entry pass in the paint. He got it up and in. The Spiders did a great job of going through the high post on that.
They got the ball to the big guy at the high post, and the D just couldn't react in time, Gus. That's often the case when the ball goes into that area of the court.
Shots off. On the right side. He looks for three. Shots off. What a rebound. The Friars are doing a great job of controlling the pace of this game.
I'll tell you, if you make the opposition play at your pace, it can really get them out of their comfort zone.
Heat check time from long range.
That's how to stretch the defense, Gus. If you can make those, offensively your team becomes really difficult to guard.
Great anticipation defensively. Around the perimeter. He attempts the three. And no! Rips it down. Out on the right wing. Lobs it inside. The Friars are controlling the pace of the game.
They're doing a terrific job at playing their game. Really making a conscious effort to control the tempo and imposing their will on the opposition.
On the right side. And he lays it up and in. Cross court. Up and in. Ha ha! When he has the ball, he's a threat to get it to the rim.
Boy, this kid has shown us some great ability. Just does a great job putting the ball on the deck and attacking the tin.
Now with the ball screen. He shoots from outside.
Got it!
That was a nice play, Rad.
They got that one because they played through the high post, Gus. A great way to attack any type of defense is through the high post.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Fires. And hits. On the left side. Down the lane. Finger roll. So easy for this guy. Looking for a good shot. And lays it in. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. way out on the right wing.
Put a little English on it.
The Friars are really controlling the tempo.
Doing a nice job of controlling the speed of the game, Gus. They're really dialed in here, and coach has got to enjoy it.
On the wing. He shoots from the corner. The senior.
Nice job there of hitting that mid-range shot. There was a time when guys were reluctant to take that shot.
Out on the left wing. 7 minutes left on the game clock. Tump it inside. Can finish. The Spiders got some good ball reversals. Coach has to be happy with the offensive execution.
Some great swing passes, ball reversal, getting them the open looks. Exactly what they want right now, Gus.
How about the action so far, Coach? Some good postseason tournament action. I'm certain the people watching are enjoying this one. Neither team backing down at this point.
I'll tell you what makes the NCAA so special is the fact that it takes one bad night. One bad night, and your season is over. It's going to be a shame that when the final horn sounds, one of these very competitive teams will be out, and their season will be over.
Both teams looking to get in a bit of a rhythm here. Out on the wing. He fires it up and answers. 6 minutes left on the game clock. Looking for a good shot.
Inside.
A terrific backdoor play on that last trip.
Oh, really caught the D on their heels. A great cut to the rim. A terrific feed for that easy completion.
He shoots from the corner and misses.
And he looks to outlet.
On the left side. That's going to be a backcourt violation, Bill.
I guess you would say the defense did their job.
And let's take a look at a player who's been all over the court.
You know, he's really a solid young player. He's been doing it all out there. Obviously, a lot of fun to watch.
They're set to throw it in from the side. The Friars motion for a round one.
Understanding what type of shot you want is essential in this offense.
They work it around the perimeter. In the lane. He missed it. Grabs the rebound. Down in the low block. Ah, he got it up and in. 5 minutes left on the game clock. The Friars set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
Now we've got a turnover. Here they go in transition. Shots off. Gets the rebound. On the left side. And we're staying right here. Inbounds play on the baseline. The Friars now running the four around one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep one.
Out on the left wing. We're at the 4 minute mark. Way out on the right wing. 10 on the shot clock. And he can't get the bounce.
I own it.
The Friars running their zone offense.
Now this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
Shots up. He can't get it to go. Pulls it in. They work it around the perimeter.
The sophomore.
They work the perimeter.
Look at that block. Terrific.
Three minutes left on the game clock. On the left side. And he lays it up and in. How about that play? They went through the high post.
Whenever you're attacking a zone or man D, it's key to get the ball in the center of the floor, and in particular, to the high post.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Up and in. Ha ha! They work it around the perimeter.
Down the lane. Finger work. So easy.
On the wing. In the lane. The junior. We are at the 2 minute mark. On the left side. Bad decision there by the senior. On the left side. On the left side. One minute left on the game clock. Takes the pass in the paint. And lays it in. Terrific look at their ability to reverse the ball.
When your team can get the ball moving like that, it can be very difficult to guard, Gus. If you can do it on a regular basis, you'll just wear the defense down.
No luck from downtown. On the left side. Ten on the shot clock. Off the mark, takes the ball. With the first half in the books, we're now ready for the road to the Final Four. Stay tuned. Here is a look at how the numbers stack up for each team here today. We can see here how both teams are doing with the keys they identify at the outset. Second half of play, coach, NCAA tournament. Doesn't get much bigger than this. Who's going to fight to ensure that they move on to the next round? The answer, just a moment.
I'll tell you what, momentum is so important right now. One of the goals for either team should be to get on a little run, get a bit of separation, and then force the opponent to make plays and come from behind to win.
You bet. Friars now running a zone offense.
The impact very similar to their man-to-man. They find the open guy.
Holland receives the ball. He shoots from the deep corner. No.
Transition.
Short receives the pass. Jump shot. It won't fall. Watch out. Bam. They work the perimeter. He puts up the tray with no luck.
They should look to push it now. A little woo-woo, Gus.
Out on the wing. Let's take a moment and look at this slam again.
Send it in, Gus.
The Friars, and they're in their motion offense, working with four around one.
Well, if you have a big guy that can find people, it really puts a lot of pressure on the D.
Entry pass in the paint. Called for the foul. Here's another solid junior build.
By the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's about leading by example and guiding the younger players on the team.
Makes it. They may have him in some trouble here, Rat.
What a great trap, Gus. The defense is getting after it.
Samuel handles the feed in the lane. And he gets it. This guy is really known as a power guy.
He's a banger, Gus. Uses that bulk and size to score in the 3-second lane.
In the lane. No! Pulls down the rebound. Samuel handles the pass. Shots off. Pulls down the board. Tump it inside.
Put a little English on it.
Short receives the ball. Fires. He got it. Sensational dribble penetration, Bill.
Gus, he put the ball to the floor with conviction and drove it home.
He throws it up from downtown. Can't connect from the three-point line.
That's a good stop defensively. One shot and get it out.
Short handles the pass. First team foul. This layup is definitely worth a second look.
Gotta make those, Gus. It's incredibly deflating when you don't. Seniors are important, Gus, because they bring so much to the table in terms of experience, accountability, and consistency. As a coach, I like to have guys like that on the roster who you can depend on.
Gotta make the freebies, Billy. Dump it inside. Block shot. And he's fouled. To the charity stripe.
Freebies important.
Sinks it. Foul shot. may be in some trouble. The trap's in place, Rat. He comes away with it. On the inside. Can finish. On the right side. In the lane.
How about this kid, huh?
They've worked the perimeter.
Inside.
On the left side. Got it up and in. On the outside. And he lays it up and in. Cross court. Up and in. Ha ha. Here's the lob. Intercepted. Now they work it around the perimeter. Gilliam manages to keep it in. And we're going the other way. The Friars have really been able to step it up. And so far, they're putting together a pretty good effort.
As a coach, it's great to see all five guys on the floor working together. That is impressive. That's how you win, and win consistently, Gus. When multiple people contribute, it takes the pressure off your superstar.
Spiders running their zone offense.
Very effective because of the power on the glass. It opens up that opportunity for tips.
Short gets the pass. He missed it.
Give me that.
Holland receives the pass. Dials up a long-range shot. Outside, Jay won't go.
It's all about shot selection, Gus. So important to take good shots, and not necessarily the shot the defense wants you to take.
Albert handles the feed. He shoots from the top of the key. He can't get the bucket to fall. Dump it inside. Turnover. He'll want that one back. Pushing in transition. And he can't get them out. What a rebound. Oh, handles the feed. He tries the three. But he misses his target. Hoover receives the ball. Jump shot. Nice. Out on the left wing. Barry. on the wing. Fires. The shot won't fall. Pushes it. Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
That's a pretty good trap there, Gus. They came together, shut down the passing lanes, and had him locked up.
On the left side. 8 minutes left on the game clock. Turns it over. Wade gets the pass. He shoots from the left side of the circle.
Big time dagger. Oh, I love seeing that, Gus. A player step up and hit that mid-range jumper.
Steals the pass. They work it around the perimeter. Down the lane.
Finger roll. So easy.
Lobs it. Change of possession. Let's get another look at the layup.
You've got to make these inside ones, Gus. They're high percentage shots. They just got to be completed.
Raph, it's obvious that the tournament is very competitive this year. These two teams have shown that they belong. They played great in the first half, and now it's likely that this contest will go down to the wire.
Hey, Gus, I think this is going right to the finish line. I think this game may come down to the last possession. These teams are competing and executing to a very high level. I mean, they're making every big shot, both of these clubs.
On the left side.
And lays it in.
The Friars have controlled the tempo here.
Gotta love the way they've come out here and really focused on their game plan. They've done a good job making sure the game is being played at their pace.
Out on the left wing.
Put a little English on it.
On the right wing. Heat check time from long range. He misses from long range. 6 minutes left on the game clock. Now they work it around the perimeter. And we'll head back down to the other end. The Friars are firing on all cylinders right now.
They're moving without it, spacing the floor, and executing when they get the open look. That's just fundamental hoops right there.
Jumped in front to take it away. On the right side. Jump shot. He can't get it to go.
Oh, physical play.
Way out on the right wing. Now we've got a turnover. Minutes left on the game clock. Dump it inside. He takes the shot from the baseline. Buries it. On the left side. He shoots from downtown. It's no good. And we have a change in possession here. This one's coming in from the baseline. The Friars set up into their four around one offense.
If you have a good postman, he's very tough to defend. Everything centers on him.
Oh, on the left side. In the lane. And he can't hit the shot. Hoover receives the ball. Can finish. The Friars working, changing it up against the zone.
And that's what makes them tough to defend. They understand how to take advantage of openings.
We're at the 4-minute mark. Hopkins with the ball. Rejected. Now in transition. Manley on the left side.
How about that elevation?
Big finish coming here, Rath, and we're staying put.
Offensively, this is when the star players should have the ball, Gus. It's time for the playmakers to step up and lead their team to victory.
With the alley-oop. In the lane. Can't put it down. Left on the game clock. Portis takes the pass. Shot clock shows 10.
Dagger!
And we'll get a change of possession. Let's check out this picture-perfect J one more time.
How about that, Gus? Does a terrific job of locking it in on the target. Lifting his elbow, following through. Get the puppy set.
The Spiders set up into their zone motion offense.
And this is difficult because they understand how to take advantage of mismatches.
They work the perimeter. He puts up the tray. Comes up empty from deep. They get the offensive rebound and put back.
Once again, nobody checked out. That coach is going to be beside himself.
Welcome back, and we're set to inbound after the timeout. The Friars now running the four around one.
Must be alert on that defensive end because guys get pinned and they can step out and knock down the deep one.
Coffey receives the pass. He throws up the shot. No!
Great inside control.
The Spiders setting up their offense.
Two guards, two forwards, and the center who plays high. Seldom does he go to the low box area, so you really extend your big guy against their big guy who generally can shoot the three.
The Friars on offense. They have four guys on the perimeter and one down low.
Great passing lanes to the big fella.
Holland handles the pass. I think this one's going the other way.
I think so too, Gus. Great call by the refs.
The Spiders are really taking it to them in the paint.
Points in the paint have been huge for them, Gus. Takes the pressure off everybody. They've demonstrated the paint is their area to control, and that's where they're looking to attack.
on the right side. The shot clock down to 10. Drains it. What a pass on the backdoor cut.
Get out of my way!
The Friars running their zone offense.
Now, this particular offense is extremely tough because they get into the high-low look.
Wade gets the ball. Let's it go! Off the mark.
They've got to fill the lanes now. Get out and fill, please.
Looking for a good shot. He launches the bomb.
Now they really have to foul Loader to stop the clock, Gus. Some people dread this part of the game, Gus, when the losing team is fouling in order to stop the clock.
And the foul will stop the clock momentarily. And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good strategy.
Let's get another look at the layup.
You've got to make these inside ones, Gus. They're high percentage shots. They've just got to be completed.
And I think that's his disqualifying foul. And, of course, another foul as they try to remain close.
Not much else they can do.
At the line. No doubt about it. Shot not good. And after the timeout, we're all set to pick things up. The Friars set up for around one.
Just tough because guys can make shots and yet they can penetrate the kick.
And they continue to foul to stop the clock.
Good strategy.
Tip in.
Those are effort points. No blockout. Those will kill you. Capitalizing on miscues.
He can't get the hoop to fall. Well, Bill, sometimes statistics lie, but in NCAA tournament basketball, I don't think they do. The better team won, and they're going on.
Well, when you take a close look at this victory, it came down to execution. We say it all the time, but these guys did a terrific job of getting stops at the defensive end and scores at the offensive end.
Ladies and gentlemen, that's all for now. Tune in for more college basketball action on CBS Sports, brought to you by EA Sports. For Bill Raftery, I'm Gus Johnson.